Shalom, shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, glory, honor due unto Yahweh. Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. Bahashem, Rahakadash. Double honors to the apostles, elders, and prophets. And no respect to the brothers teaching truth all over the globe. In the title of this lesson, I have to put out an article from Yahoo News. You know, this article said, I am being how Israel could use lasers to kill Iran's missiles in a war. You know, that's from Yahoo News right there, and that's the, you know, that's the article. You know, if you really want to do a lesson, you can feel free to do so. And the Israel is talking about is not talking about, you know, the true people of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, which consist of you blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, that you are the true biblical Israelites that spoke of in the scriptures. But the Israel that this is talking about those, the fake Jews over there, those Khazarians over there. You know, and they figure that they got these laser beams they could use to stop these missiles from hitting this place, you know, hitting their place. You know, but the Most High, you know, has a special treat for those people over there in Israel. Let me get a quick scripture that shows that these people are not the real people of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah. And the scripture I'm going to read is Revelation chapter 2. It's going to start at verse 9. It says, I know thy works in the tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of saints. And that shows you right there in the scriptures that these people that are over there in our land is not the real Jews. You know, they're the synagogue of saints. You know, they pretending to be us. Because if they were the real Jews, you know, as the scriptures speak of, then Yahweh should already been returned by now. And the kingdom of heaven already be established and all the other nations will be in slavery. And the scripture also said we won't study war anymore, you know, if they were the real Jews. Because scriptures also tells that all 12 tribes going to be together anyway. And those folks are not the real Jews. And another scripture, you know, sent them in out of Revelation 2:9. This is Revelation 3, chapter 3, verse 9. It reads, behold, I make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet and to know that I have loved thee. And this is show you right there that if these were the real Jews or what have not, you know, that, you know what I'm saying, all the other nations would come and bow down to them and worship at their feet, you know, where Yahweh shall be in prison there. But this shows you that these people are not the real Jews, man. They're not. They're the synagogue of saints. You know, they're Khazars. You know, they basically, you know, they're Edomites as well. You know, you got the Amalekites. They're too. And they also are the upclass of Edomites. You know, your so-called, elites that claim that they are trying to claim their Jewish heritage. But they're Edomites as well. Because they were the true Jews. Guess what? The true Jews, you know, they've been enslaved because the scripture prophesied that, you know, since our people disobeyed the law, statutes, commandments, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, we got put under the curses. So we're not rich on this side, man. You know, for those who are rich on this side, you know, black, Latino, Native American, you know, they had to sell out. But anyway, getting back on point with the article, you know, sorry to ramble on a little bit. But it said, I am being how Israel could use lasers to kill Iran missiles in a war. It reads, Iran's bold summer campaign against U.S. allies and interests in the Persian Gulf, including military support for Houthini rebels and alleged drone strikes against Saudi Arabia, has allowed Jerusalem to the prospect of an intimate Israel-Iran conflict, shining a critical spotlight on the core pillar of Israel's defense deterrent against Iran, its anti-air system, and it's a Israel and Iran conflict. You know, it's gonna be a conflict that cannot be avoided because the scriptures, you know, tell us that, you know, all these nations are gonna fight in the valley of Jehoshaphat. You know, Israel gonna be involved in it. The U.S. gonna be involved in every nation. You know that all the nations that, you know, will benefit for the downfall of you Black, Latino, Native Americans gonna be over there in the Middle East. You know, it's gonna be the War of Armageddon, the Valley of Jehoshaphat. And they trying to say that they had these laser beams, you know, that's going to stop, you know, the missile from coming over there. But we already know that Yahweh Shem HaShai is gonna put his spirit on those missiles. And then one of the missiles is going to break their ranks, you know what I'm saying? That's roughly paraphrasing. You know, because Yahweh Shem HaShai is going to have the missiles to hit their precise target where he wanted to go. So, I don't care how many laser beams or whatever they shoot, they might hit the missiles. But it's not going to deter the missiles because the spirit of Yahweh Shem HaShai is going to be on those missiles. And continuing on, it said the operation has logistical flaws. In the Israeli Defense Force, you know, IDF, technically impressive but expensive and unwieldy for tier missiles defense shield has reignited Israeli interest in laser technology. Contrary to popular belief, the concept of energy-based weaponry is neither novel nor futuristic. Because, let me say this, because, you know, we all know that Esau Edom, weapon is, he's gonna, by his sword he shall live. And what's his sword? His sword is the modern gun, the modern weaponry. And our people, you know, the true Jews don't have any weaponry. We don't have any military might because our people was taken down because of our disobedience to the Most High, to Yahweh Shem HaShai. And we waiting on Yahweh Shem HaShai to deliver us. You know, the scripture said, you know, wait upon me. You know, said, Lord, in the day that I rise up to the prey. So we're waiting on Yahweh to return, along with and Joseph, the host of angels, to deliver us out of this captivity, you know, out of Babylon the Great. You know, we don't have any missiles. We don't have any laser system, any of that stuff. We don't have any weaponry. And then even with the guns that these Black, Latino, Native Americans have, it's not gonna do us no good. Because guess what? If you're part of the whole flesh, you know the Most High is gonna deliver you anyway. He's gonna deliver you out of the snare of the fowler. He's gonna deliver you out of the time of trouble because Isaiah 59:19 said that even though the enemy comes in like a flood, but the spirit of Yahweh Shem HaShai gonna lift up and stand against them. You know, these people were the true Jews that the Bible speak of. You know, they won't have all these weaponry. They will not have a defense system. They will not be getting funded, $3 billion every year. You know, from the United States going to this welfare state of Israel. These people are benefiting off. You know, they benefiting off our name. You know, they saying that they are the true people and not. And these people just saying that they Israel, you know if they're the true Israelites, they shouldn't have no weaponry, you know what I'm saying? They should be rounded up in slavery, you know. They should be at the bottom. They should be poor, you know what I'm saying? The curses should follow them everywhere they go. But guess what? They benefit, you know. They got technology, you know. They got all these things. That shows you that they're not the true Jews or what the Bible speaks of. Continuing on, let me read there again. It said, contrary to popular belief, the concept of energy-based weaponry is not a novel nor futuristic. The Israelis have been evaluating projects along the line since the early 2000s, when a laser missile defense system was proposed as an alternative to the Iron Dome short-range air defense system. The dome eventually won out, with the Israeli Defense Ministry concluding that laser technology had not and not yet mature into a cost-effective and operation sound investment. And that shows you right there that these Israelis that are in the land, they are Edomites. Because guess what? You know, by the sword they're going to live. You know, by the sword they took the land of Israel, you know, in the declaration, Balfour Declaration on December 14, 1948. They took the land upon themselves. The scripture prophesied that they're going to take the land of Israel for themselves, you know, roughly paraphrasing. And they saying that they are the true Jews, they're the true people of the Bible, which we know that's not so. But continuing on, it said, but Israeli defense firm Rafael Advanced Defense System resumed R&D work on a laser-based missile defense prototype in 2009. Rafael System unveiled an early concept model named the Iron Beam High Energy Laser at the 2014 Singapore Air Show. That system employed dual multi-kilowatt solid-state lasers, compact with any radar and capable of being mounted on a wide range of vehicles. Sources differ on precise details, but Iron Beam is currently thought to have a maximum effect range of up to 7 kilometers and is reported capable of destroying missiles. Unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs, are mortar shells around 4 seconds after the twin high energy fiber optic lasers to make contact with their target. And they're let you know right there that these people are not the true Jews, man. Because like I said before, you know, according to the scriptures, the true Jews don't have a military might. You know, our people at the bottom, and also our people are scattered throughout the four corners of the globe. You know, we defenseless. That's the reason why we have to wait on Yahushua to return. We have to wait on him and the jealous host of angels to come back to deliver us. And these Israelis, you know, they got all these missiles, defense systems, they got all this stuff that shows you they're not the true Jews. Because guess what? Like I said before, we don't have any military might. Our military might is in Yahushua. The scriptures also tell us, like I said before, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. They are mighty and they are pulling down strongholds. Guess what? We don't have carnal weapons. We don't have any weaponry. You name any black Latino Native American, which are the true Israelites, you know, have their own defense system. You know, you cannot name one because guess what? Our weapons of our warfare are not carnal. We don't have that type of capability to do that. Because guess what? Because all the knowledge that we have got stripped from us. Even though that we invent a lot of things, you know, but guess what? You know, guess what? Most High gave Esau that spirit to build all types of weapons. You know, different types of weapons. They even got unmanned UAVs, man. You know, vehicles that can drive themselves. You know, they can go in and they can use those vehicles to do what they want to do because Job 9:24 said the earth is given to the hand of the wicked. You know, and they able to do all these things because Most High put the spirit upon them to build weapons. Why he do that? Because he gonna build the weapons so they can he can use it to destroy them, man. You know, all this talk about Israel had all these lasers to trying to stop these missiles. They're not going to be able to stop them missiles. You know, Most High going to put his spirit upon them missiles. And a missile going to hit their precise target. And the scriptures say, roughly paraphrasing, that ain't that one of the missiles going to break their range. You know, it basically arrows, but we know it's talking about the missiles. No, we're talking about the warheads. They're not going to break their range. They're going to hit their precise target. And that's the same way it's going to happen here over here in Babylon the Great when 200 million missiles get shot over here. And ain't one missile going to break their range. He's going to tear this place to smithereens. You know, after saying that, on the things they're going to dwell here is going to be the desert creatures. There's not no man going to inhabit this place again. This place is going to be totally destroyed. And guess what? In that same way with Israel, you know, those fake Jews over there, the Most High going allow the missiles to wipe them Jews off our homeland. You know, they don't get wiped out our land. And then guess what? They don't come back in the kingdom. They gonna rebuild our kingdom. You can read that in Isaiah chapter 14, around the second verse. You know, we're gonna be ruling all our oppressors. It don't matter what type of weapon system they got on inside. That you know, they ain't not gonna stop the will of Yahweh by Shimei HaShai. He's gonna allow them missiles that they, you know, that the other nations are gonna shoot, gonna allow them to destroy. You know, they're gonna wipe them people Israel out of the land. And that's what it is. And we all know that that's part of war and that rumors of wars, man. You know, they getting prepared because, you know, Joel chapter 3, verse 9, you know, it reads to the fact that, you know, that let the men beat their plowshares to pruning hooks and let the wheat stay out and strong. You got all the other nations that are building nuclear technology, nuclear tech capability, especially Iran. And Iran's main intent is to destroy them Israelites, well, them so-called Jews over there in the land of Israel. You know, a president, one of the prime minister a while back, the president over in Iran, I think his name was Amirjab, or I can't think of his name, who was a president in Iran before. His whole purpose was to wipe out the Israel over there, the fake Jews. His main purpose, he wanted to wipe them out. And it's gonna be that war. You know, it's gonna be that war in the Middle East, the Battle of Jehoshaphat, the war of Armageddon. All these things gonna come to pass. And that's what scripture tells us, that, you know, Matthew 24, it's gonna be wars of rumor, wars, see ye be not troubled. All these things gonna come to pass, but the end is not yet. You know, real paraphrase, the end is not by and by. All these things are gonna come to pass. And then Israel is going to get nuked. You know what I'm saying? It's going to get nuked according to the scriptures. Not according to what I say. It's according to what the scriptures say. The scripture tells us that you know, even in this place, Babylon the Great is going to get wiped out. It's going to be destroyed. You know, all them fake Jews are going to be destroyed out of the land of Israel. And that's just what it is. Like I said before, ain't my technology is gonna stop the spirit of Yahweh by Hashem outside. You know, they can try to build all types of lasers, all this stuff. But guess what? When Most High put his spirit upon the missile, them laser beams ain't gonna do nothing. They're not gonna even face them missiles. Missiles gonna come over there gonna destroy the people there in our land. You're gonna destroy those people. And guess what? Same people that thought that they were gonna inherit our land, how about Shimei HaShai is going to raise them back up in the kingdom, and they're going to be rebuilding our place. They're going to be as slaves. You know, that's it for a lesson. You know, just want to do a quick touch and go on this lesson about Israel, the laser defense system. You know, they claim that they trying to perfect their laser device so that way they could stop the missiles. They ain't going to be able to stop the missiles. They're not. The Most High going to allow the missiles to hit Israel. It's gonna wipe them Israels off, the Israelis that in our land, gonna wipe them off the map, and they're gonna do the same thing Babylon the Great. You know, it is what it is, and that's what's gonna happen. You know, that's it for lesson. I pray that you were edified. I want to say, call the Hoya, Yahweh Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shah, Baal Hashem, Rahakadosh, double honors to the apostle, elders, and prophets. Another respect to the brothers, teach the truth all over the globe. I'll see you again with another lesson real soon. Yahweh willing. Shalom, Ababa Baal, and Kwame Yasharala.